Hello friends, today we'll see Booth's multiplication algorithm, right? Booth's algorithm for multiplication. Now in this we have one example, that is multiplier is 001100 and multiplicand is 010011. So this is what we have to take the multiplication of these two numbers, right? So for Booth's algorithm, first we have to recode the multiplier. And you know, before recoding, for recoding, you refer my previous video. See how you can recode this. So I'll write actual multiplier as 001100. And remember, here we have to append one zero. That is the first step. After that, what we have to find? We have to find the recoded multiplier. Right, so how you have to find? If the 0 to 0 if you are moving right to left and the 0 to 0 means for same bits, then you have to write 0. 0 to 0 write 0. 0 to 1 write minus 1. 1 to 1 0. 1 to 0 plus 1. 0 to 0 0. So this is what your recoded multiplier, that is 0 plus 1 0 minus 1 0 0. So this is what the multiplier we have to use for multiplication, that is for multiplication. Okay, we'll see actual multiplication. So I'll write multiplicand, that is 010011. Okay, and next number is, that is multiplier, recorded multiplier is what? 0 plus 1 0 minus 1 0 0. And what do I have to take? I have to take the multiplication of it. Okay, so remember how many bits are here? 1 2 3 4 5 6. So if you are taking the multiplication of n bit, so result, whatever the result you are getting, that result required may 2n bits, right? So 2n bits means, so total we need 12 bits, right? So remember, 12 bits are required for result, right? So I'll take the multiplication. So if we are multiplying by 0, so all zeros we have to write for partial product. So this is the partial product after multiplying by 0. So how many zeros I have to write? 12 zeros. 3 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is actual 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, then again 0, you have to multiply by 0. So I'll skip one place and I'll write from 0. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and this 0. Okay. Now in next step, see, this is very important step. You are multiplying by minus 1. And what is the meaning of this? If you are multiplying by minus 1 in Booth's algorithm, then we have to write the multiplicand, 2's complement of multiplicand. And if you are multiplying by plus 1, you have to write that as a partial product as actual multiplicand. So remember, I am multiplying by minus 1, you have to take the 2's complement of multiplicand. So what is the 2's complement of multiplicand? That is 101101. So skip one place and start from this place, right? 101101. Now these places also we have to fill. So how you can fill? So remember, we have to extend the sign bit. So this is the sign bit of this multiplicand, means what? 2's complement of that multiplicand, we have to extend by this. So 1 1 1 and 1, this is very important step. Now after that, we have to multiply by 0. So remember, skip 1 and start writing zeros, because we are multiplying by zeros, partial product is all 0. Plus 1, write the multiplicand as it is. So 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. These two will be filled by 0 because we are extending the sign bit as 0 as it is, right? After that, by 0. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. So now we have to take the addition of this. Okay. So see, I'll take the addition of this. So what will be the addition? This will be 0, 0, 1, 0. 1 plus 1 is 0 with carry 1. 1, 1, 1. 3 times 1 is 1 with carry 1. That is 1. 1 plus all 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1 plus 1 as 0 with carry 1. 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1. So 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1. Right? But the result is in 2's complement, right? So whatever the negative numbers we are representing, that is 2's complement form. So we have to ignore in 2's complement form. We have to ignore the carry in 2's complement form. So actual, this is what the actual result. So plus 20 plus, this is the positive result. And this is the actual magnitude of the result. Okay. This is what the multiplication by using Boots algorithm. Thanks for watching this video. We'll see hardware implementation of Boots algorithm in next video.